Hello, my name is Sadalee Kraus. I'm a pediatric nurse here at Lehigh Valley Health Network. Today we're going to review infant, child, and adult choking rescue. To provide choking rescue for a child over the age of one or an adult, you're going to follow these steps. Step one, if you see an adult or child who appears to be choking, observe them for a few seconds. Step two, if they can talk or cough, no intervention is needed. Step three, if they cannot talk, cough, or are making high-pitched noise, you must act fast. Step four, ask the person if they are choking. If they nod yes, tell them you're going to help them. First, stand behind the victim. Next, place your arms around the victim just above the belly button and well below the tip of the breastbone. Then, make a fist with your thumb against the victim's skin. Place your other hand over the hand already on the victim's body. Pull in and up like you're scooping ice cream to force the object out. This technique is called abdominal thrust. Continue with abdominal thrust until the object was removed or the victim becomes unresponsive. Call 911 immediately if the victim becomes unresponsive. Begin CPR and continue until professional help arrives. To provide choking rescue for an infant, step one, if you see an infant that appears to be choking, observe for a few seconds. If they are crying or coughing, just observe. If they are making a high-pitched squeal or no sound at all, you must act fast. Step two, place the infant face down on your arm, supporting their head and neck with your hand. Straddle the infant's legs over your arm. Deliver 5 back blows to the middle of the infant's back. Step three, roll the infant over to your other arm, again supporting their head and neck with your hand. Step four, look in the infant's mouth to check for the object. If it's at the lips, you can remove it. Note, do not ever use a finger sweep as this may push the object back down. Step five, deliver 5 chest compressions on the breastbone just below the nipple line. Step six, continue alternating back blows and chest compressions until the object comes out or the infant becomes unresponsive. Step seven, if a child or infant becomes unresponsive, call 911 immediately and begin CPR. Remember, the most important step you can take is to prevent the choking in the first place. Ways to prevent choking. Do, cut food into small bite-sized pieces. Chop round foods into quarter-sized pieces to lose their round shape. Take small bites and chew well. Alternate liquids and solids. Sit down and stay with the infant and small children while eating or drinking. Make sure the child sits in the high chair or infant seat while eating or drinking. Place small objects out of the reach of infants and small children. Do not give infants and small children hard foods like candy, raw carrots, apples, nuts, or popcorn. Do not give infants and small children smooth, round food like hot dogs or grapes or food that can get stuck in the back of the mouth like peanut butter or marshmallows. Do not allow children to play with balloons, coins, button batteries, hair clips or ties, marbles, small toys or game pieces, or dolls or stuffed animals with button-type eyes. These are the techniques taught through the American Heart Association CPR Family and Friends program. For best practice, we encourage you to take an in-person, hands-on class with guided instruction for both CPR and choking rescue.